To explain the etiology of chronic myeloid leukemia, we have to know how Philadelphia chromosome is formed. And to explain this, we have to recall the basic concepts. Here we have a pair of chromosomes 9. Chromosomes can exchange genetic information by crossover mechanism. But in normal condition, this crossover is possible only between homologous chromosomes. Basically, it's the chromosomes that have the same structure. To make it simple, crossover is possible only between the chromosomes that have the same number. So chromosome 9 can switch genetic information only with another chromosome 9. But chromosome 9 cannot make a crossover with chromosome 22, for example. Because in normal condition, the crossover between different chromosomes is impossible. But sometimes mutation can disrupt normal metabolism, and this can cause pathological crossover between non-homologous chromosomes. And exactly this happens in chronic myeloid leukemia. So initially we have stem cell. In this stem cell, we have a chromosome 9. We have to know that on chromosome 9 located ABL1 gene that encodes a specific enzyme called tyrosine kinase. The function of tyrosine kinase is to activate proteins that are responsible for cellular proliferation. And activation of proteins occurs by phosphorylation. In order to activate proteins, tyrosine kinase uses ATP molecule. By ATP molecule, it phosphorylates proteins and as a byproduct, ADP is released. Important that tyrosine kinase involved primarily in regulation of granulocytopoiesis. So basically, this enzyme regulates the production of granulocytes. As we know, hematopoiesis can be subdivided on myelopoiesis and lymphopoiesis. And myelopoiesis can be subdivided on erythropoiesis, thrombopoiesis, monocytopoiesis, and finally granulopoiesis. And to the final products of granulopoiesis belongs neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils. So basically, the higher will be the amount of activated proteins that stimulate proliferation of granulocytes, the higher will be the production of neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils, so the higher will be the quantity of these cells in the blood. Important that tyrosine kinase serves as a conductor. It receives signal by cytokines and only then begins to phosphorylate intracellular proteins. Recall that because cytokines have protein structure and proteins are polar molecules, they cannot diffuse into the cell. They require some receptor that on the surface of the cell will receive signal and transmit this signal into the nucleus. So when cytokines act on cytokine receptor on cellular surface, it requires tyrosine kinase to deliver this signal into the nucleus. So basically, tyrosine kinase is just a conductor. In normal condition, tyrosine kinase cannot decide to increase the mitotic rate or to leave it as it is. Because basically, tyrosine kinase do not know how to regulate. This enzyme just acts. We can think of tyrosine kinase as of a common factory worker. They do not know how the entire process works, but they certainly know they are part of the job. The engineers here are the cells that compose very complex structure called bone marrow microenvironment. These cells are really smart guys. They are located in the bone marrow, and by the secretion of cytokines, they regulate the amount of cells in the blood, including the amount of granulocytes. So cells from the bone marrow microenvironment cannot act directly. They secrete cytokines in hopes that tyrosine kinase will receive this signal and will provide adequate response. For example, the amount of neutrophils in the blood decrease. They sense that the amount of neutrophils begin to decrease. In order to correct this, cells from bone marrow microenvironment secrete various cytokines, as granulocyte macrophage colony stimulating factor, interleukin-3 or interleukin-6. These cytokines stimulate tyrosine kinase, and in response to this, tyrosine kinase phosphorylates and thereby activates proteins that are responsible for cellular proliferation. As a result, the amount of granulocytes, in this case neutrophils, will increase. And by this we maintain the normal quantity of granulocytes in the blood. Important that when granulocytes reach normal values, bone marrow microenvironment begin to decrease the production of cytokines. so the stimulation of tyrosine kinase will decrease, so the activation of proteins that are responsible for cellular proliferation will decrease, thereby the production of neutrophils will decrease. But sometimes mutations can occur. Usually, in hematopoiesis, mutations occur in a stage of stem cell. And this mutation forced chromosome 9 to make a pathological crossover with chromosome 22. So we have chromosome 22, and on chromosome 22 located the gene called BCR. We do not really know the function of BCR gene yet, but we know that on chromosome 22, this gene is very active. So if mutation in stem cell occurs that will cause reciprocal translocation between chromosome 9 and 22, the ABL1 gene from chromosome 9 will be translocated to chromosome 22 in exchange for a part of chromosome 22 region. As a result, now ABL1 gene is located near the BCR gene on chromosome 22. And because BCR gene is very active, it stimulates the activity of ABL1 gene. So this mutation causes formation of a fusion gene called BCR-ABL1, where ABL1 has very high activity. And because ABL1 encodes tyrosine kinase, now with this mutation, because ABL1 becomes extremely active, tyrosine kinase becomes constantly active, in fact, practically uncontrollable. With increase in activity of tyrosine kinase, phosphorylation and thereby activation of proteins that are responsible for proliferation increase, thereby granulocyte production increase, as a result the amount of neutrophils, basophils and eosinophils in the blood begin to progressively increase. So, if in normal condition, tyrosine kinase is active only when bone marrow microenvironment will send signal by cytokines, now tyrosine kinase is acting on its own, basically brainlessly. So with constantly active tyrosine kinase, now we have constant proliferation of the granulocytes, so the amount of granulocytes in the bone marrow and thereby in the blood will progressively increase. And exactly overproduction with progressive accumulation of the granulocytes in the blood called chronic myeloid leukemia. And chromosome 22 that is formed by pathological reciprocal translocation with BCR-ABL1 gene called Philadelphia chromosome. If you like content, please press like and subscribe button. All the best!